In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is a happy moment which brings us together on the eve of the Paschal Triduum to hold in our prayer as the holy oils are blessed and consecrated, all those in our diocese who will be anointed in baptism, in confirmation, in the hour of sickness, including their last, and to give thanks for the priesthood and our priests, through whose consecrated hands the Eucharistic sacrifice is offered and the sacraments of salvation are brought to us. And I want to single out one priest, if I may, the Vicar General, Canon Phil Moore, who in recovering from serious illness is joining us this evening by live feed in order to be united with us in prayer and in the renewal of the priestly promises. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me, the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Christ have mercy, Christe eleison, Christe eleison. Lord have mercy, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace.
Let us pray. O God, who anointed your only begotten Son with the Holy Spirit and made him Christ and Lord, graciously grant that being made sharers in his consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the poor, to bind up hearts that are broken, to proclaim liberty to captives, freedom to those in prison, to proclaim a year of favor from the Lord, a day of vengeance for our God, to comfort all those who mourn, and to give them for ashes a garland, for mourning robe, the oil of gladness, for despondency, praise. But you will be named priests of the Lord. They will call you ministers of our God. I reward them faithfully and make an everlasting covenant with them. Their race will be famous throughout the nations, their descendants throughout the peoples. All who see them will admit that they are a race whom the Lord has blessed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God, the rock who set me. Reading from the book of the Apocalypse. Grace and peace to you from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, the ruler of the kings of the earth. He loves us and has washed away our sins with his blood, and made us a line of kings, priests, to serve his God and Father. To him, then, be glory and power for ever and ever. Amen. It is he who is coming on the clouds. Everyone will see him, even those who pierced him. And all the races of the earth will mourn over him. This is the truth. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is, who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, Word of the Father, Son of God. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, Word of the Father, Son of God. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me. He has sent me to give the good news to the poor. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, Word of the Father, Son of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came to Nazareth, where he'd been brought up, and went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as he usually did. He stood up to read, and they handed him the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Unrolling the scroll, he found the place where it's written, "The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for he has anointed me. He has sent me to bring the good news to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives, to the blind new sight, to set the downtrodden free, and to proclaim the Lord's year of favor." He then rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the assistant, and sat down. All eyes in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to speak to them. "This text is being fulfilled today, even as you listen." the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
All eyes in the synagogue were fixed on him. At the beginning of my time as bishop, we prayed here in St. Michael's for the renewal of the priesthood in holiness and for the renewal of our parishes in mission. On a 3-day pilgrimage of the relic of the heart of St. John Mary Vianney. And I remember returning here on a Eucharistic pilgrimage made on my knees across the diocese to pray for new and generous vocations to the priesthood at a time when we lacked those vocations. As we heard in the synagogue of Nazareth, when all eyes turn to the Lord, then hope is fulfilled when our eyes turn to him. And tonight we happily return to St. Michael's in a Mass which invites us to give thanks for the Catholic priesthood, the vocation that does not exist for its own sake, but for the salvation of every soul. On the eve of that day, when the Catholic priesthood and the Holy Eucharist were born together, we ask that our thanksgiving may never end. Last month, I had cause for thanksgiving, reaching the 40th anniversary of my own priestly ordination. And I travelled to Lourdes not as the leader of a pilgrimage, but as a simple pilgrim to give thanks on the 11th of February, in a place where the Mother of God made her presence felt and her voice heard. The essence of the message of Lourdes is found in silence, in prayer, in the very graciousness with which Our Lady chose to stand with Bernadette in all her poverty. It reminds us, in a year when Pope Francis calls us to be renewed in the interior life of prayer, of those riches which God offers us every day in prayer, every moment in prayer. The grace of healing and conversion, which flows for us like a spring of water in that grotto of Lourdes. The need to intercede for souls destitute in sin, as Bernadette was reminded. And above all, to make a central place in our lives for the Holy Eucharist. Such was the spoken message of Lourdes. Yet the apparitions were largely the unbroken silence of prayer, in which St. Bernadette tells us something that is more than a detail, that Our Lady constantly held a rosary, a silent invitation to share the prayer of her immaculate heart. As the Gospel describes, she treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. Praying the rosary leads us to do the same, demanding, according to the Gospel imperative, that we become as a little child to contemplate Christ in his incarnation and redemption. The Church and the witness of her saints teach we will find in the Rosary the depth of the gospel message in its entirety, and a prayer destined to bring forth a harvest of holiness. This is the treasure. This is the invitation that I want to share with you for my anniversary pilgrimage. I remember the shrill tone of the hospital bleep calling me to the general hospital for the third time that night, getting up again and driving to the hospital and entering a geriatric ward. I found that I had not been called because of an emergency admission or in the hour of death, but because an elderly lady was distressed at having lost her rosary. It was 4 o'clock in the morning. I was happy to give her my own rosary and perhaps later draw a lesson never to lose hold of the rosary in my own life. A precious gift that we have received from the hands of the Mother of God to allow us to contemplate with Mary the face of Christ in the mysteries of his joy, his light, his sorrow, his glory. In the Rosary, it is with Mary's gaze and Mary's wonder that we are able to keep our eyes fixed on him. During those days in Lourdes, I realized how the Rosary had formed an unbroken chain through every day and scene of my own life, linking every moment with gospel contemplation, intercession, reparation and praise and thanksgiving to the Holy Trinity. As Pope St. John Paul reflected at the end of his life, the Rosary has accompanied me in moments of joy and moments of difficulty. To this prayer I have entrusted any number of concerns. In it I have always found consolation. May the same be true for us, especially if we have forgotten the rosary or, like the lady in the hospital, lost it along our journey. Let us be able to rediscover this path of prayer, contemplating its mysteries, not only for ourselves and our own conversion, as urgent as this is, but for all those in our lives who depend on our prayer. And taking up the impassioned plea, which became part of this Mass following the Second Vatican Council, to pray for your priests and for new vocations to the priesthood, that prompted by love alone, they may give the whole of their lives for the salvation of their brothers and sisters. And so, once more, in St. Michael and all angels, and in every church of our diocese, with Mary, may we turn our eyes to the mystery of the Eucharist, keeping our gaze fixed on him who is, who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. Beloved sons, on the anniversary of that day when Christ our Lord conferred his priesthood on his apostles and on us, are you resolved to renew in the presence of your bishop and God's holy people, the promises you once made. Are you resolved to be more united with the Lord Jesus and more closely conformed to him, denying yourselves and confirming those promises about sacred duties towards Christ's church, which, prompted by love of him, you willingly and joyfully pledged on the day of your priestly ordination? Are you resolved to be faithful stewards of the mysteries of God in the Holy Eucharist and the other liturgical rites, and to discharge faithfully the sacred office of teaching, following Christ, the head and shepherd, not seeking any gain, but moved only by zeal for souls? As for you, dearest sons and daughters, pray for your priests, that the Lord may pour out his gifts abundantly upon them and keep them faithful as ministers of Christ the High Priest, so that they may lead you to him who is the source of salvation. Pray also for me, that I may be faithful to the apostolic office entrusted to me in my lowliness, and that in your midst I may be made day by day a living and more perfect image of Christ, the priest, the good shepherd, the teacher, and the servant of all.
Christ hear us.
May the Lord keep us all in his charity and lead all of us, shepherds and flock, to eternal life.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your people, your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, will be given up for you." In similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, our spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Michael,
O God, Father of all consolation, who will to heal the infirmities of the weak through your Son, listen favorably to the prayer of faith. Send forth from the heavens, we pray, your Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, upon this oil in all its richness, which you have graciously brought forth from the verdant tree, to restore the body, so that by your holy blessing, everyone anointed with this oil as a safeguard for body, soul, and spirit may be freed from all pain, all infirmity, and all sickness. May your holy oil, O Lord, be blessed by you for our sake, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word. body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, strength and protection of your people, you have made the oil you created a sign of strength. Graciously bless this oil and grant courage to the catechumens who will be anointed with it, so that by receiving divine wisdom and power, they may understand more deeply the gospel of your Christ. They may undertake with a generous heart the labors of the Christian life, and made worthy of adoption as your sons and daughters, they may rejoice to be born anew and to live in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray, dear brothers and sisters, to God the Almighty Father, that he bless and sanctify this oil. May those who are signed with it outwardly be inwardly anointed and made worthy of divine redemption. O God, author of all growth and spiritual progress, receive in your goodness the grateful homage that the Church joyfully offers to you through our voice. For in the beginning you commanded the earth to bring forth fruit-bearing trees, among which olive trees would arise, as providers of this most rich oil, so that their fruit might serve for sacred chrism. In the spirit of prophecy, David foresaw the sacraments of your grace and sang of the oil that would gladden our faces. After the world's offenses were washed away by the flood, a dove announced the restoration of peace on earth with the olive branch, foreshadowing the gift to come. In the last days, all this has been clearly revealed. When every offense is removed through the waters of baptism, the anointing with this oil makes our faces cheerful and serene. You also commanded your servant Moses to make his brother Aaron a priest by pouring this oil upon him after he had been washed in water. Still greater dignity was added to this by your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, insisted that he be washed by John in the waters of the Jordan. You sent the Holy Spirit from on high in the likeness of a dove. You declared by the witness of the voice that followed that you were well pleased in him, your only begotten Son, and you were seen to confirm clearly what the prophet David had foretold in song, that Christ would be anointed with the oil of gladness above his companions. Therefore, we beseech you, Lord, be pleased to sanctify with your blessing this oil in its richness, and to pour forth into it the strength of the Holy Spirit with the powerful working of your Christ. From his holy name it has received the name of Chrism, and with it you have anointed your priests, prophets, kings, and martyrs. May you confirm the chrism you have created as a sacred sign of perfect salvation and life for those to be made new in the spiritual waters of baptism. May those formed into a new temple of your majesty by the holiness infused through this anointing and by the cleansing of the stain of their first birth be made fragrant with the innocence of a life pleasing to you. May those anointed with royal, priestly, and prophetic dignity be clothed with the garment of an incorruptible gift in keeping with the sacrament you have established. May this oil be the chrism of salvation for those born again of water and the Holy Spirit, and may it make them partakers of eternal life and sharers of heavenly glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Glory be to the Lord.
Thanks be to God.